I'm Renee.
Orly. Gino.
And we are here to go ahead and give our review to Big Ass Spider, coming out on DVD just this week.
Now, one of the things we're reviewing this movie is because the director, Mike Mendez, and we have one of the stars.
Lombardo Boyard.
Yeah. Lombardo Boyard coming into the Sun City Sci-Fi this March. And so we decided to do a review of the film. So you can catch it on DVD.
The title of the movie is Big Ass Spider. It's an exclamation point. So it's Big Ass Spider.
I mean, there is little left to the imagination in regards to the title. The title says exactly what the movie's about. And in fact, they don't waste any time because the first thing you see is a big-ass spider going ahead and climbing up buildings and destroying everything.
Yeah. Well, let's look at the previews. And as you're watching the video right now, I'm showing you the previews for Big-Ass Spider. We didn't see that much of it. It wasn't a wide release.
No, it wasn't.
No.
I mean, I recall seeing previews.
Yeah, I remember watching it. You know, I forgot what movie it was, but we saw it.
Yeah, I think we... Did we see it in the movie theater?
I think we watched it on certain pieces of media.
I know we saw it on TV, for sure.
Yeah.
I know we saw
yeah,
it on TV.
I know, but...
Theaters? I can't remember specifically.
I can't recall if we saw it on...
I saw it on, well, not TV, actually. I saw it on the internet, too. Maybe I might have seen
well,
it.
Well, on the internet, yeah. You know, we've seen it, especially promoting it for the Sun City. But I'm trying to think, I don't think I've seen it on TV, or maybe cable TV.
Also, I think your cable, for sure I know I saw it on the internet.
But either way, I mean, we've seen the film now. And, you know, for me... Don't be scared. I'm not scared. This is enjoyable camp. I liked it. Aggressive. I mean, you know, this is strong. No award-winning acting or anything from any of it.
Says you.
No, I do predict some awards. I do predict some awards.
Yeah.
But let me just say this. You know, me and Chino, we watch sci-fi movies.
Yeah.
We've seen Sharknado. We've seen... Sharktopus versus...
Oh, I've been thinking of all
the Mystery Science Theater 3000.
Yeah, all the MST3K stuff and all that. And this one, you know, I gotta let you know, ladies and gentlemen, it's a step above the sci-fi movies.
It's a B-movie with class, I think is the best thing I could kind of give it. It. You know, it's a B-movie. There's no escaping that. It is a B-movie.
But it was made to be camp.
It's a step up to be a B-movie.
Well, know? No, they didn't hide the fact. That's the thing about this movie. They don't hide the fact of what they are. You know, Mike Mendez did not, you know, he knew what he was shooting.
Right.
He wasn't taking himself seriously.
Yeah.
And, you know, the movie had a fun pace, and I think, you know, that's what he went to do.
It reminded me of Snakes on a Plane. In regards
I've
to...
I've never seen that. I'm never going to see that.
In regards to, it knew what it was in the very beginning. It wanted to be a movie about a big-ass spider. And that's what it was. And the thing is this. They take the conceit and, you know, no explanations needed, though there is one. But for those of us that love campy films that are made to be campy, this one follows in line. It just is fun. Doesn't... try to be anything other than that.
I think Renee, I like what Renee said. He said it's really good pacing. It is. It's really good pacing. There isn't a moment in the movie where it's not going somewhere. It's always moving forward. I like that.
Yeah, there's no downtime whatsoever.
Yeah, at all.
Throughout
the whole movie.
It was almost...
It moved fast.
Yeah. Yeah,
fast. The whole thing
from
moved fast.
From one scene to the other, and it was well connected. Well, it flowed.
As for the people in the movie, you're going to recognize a lot of them.
Ray Wise.
Yeah, I love Ray Wise.
Yeah, he's in every sci-fi movie. He's either the bad guy or he's the army general. here again, he's the army general, and man, you know, you always see those. And, you know, there's some other guys that, again, that we've seen, but never, like, starring. I mean, like the one who's coming to the Sun City, Lombardo Boyar. He's one of those guys that I know I've seen him in tons of stuff. You know, we went over on the video and he talked about his long resume and all that. And here, yeah, you know, he's the second guy, you know, and he did a great job.
Well,
yeah.
if we break it down in the story, okay, was a hero of the movie likable? Yeah, the hero of the movie's great. I like him. Was his sidekick likable? Yeah, he was likable.
Well, let me tell you.
Did they have a credible enemy? Yeah. Very credible enemy. Now, did they explain why the enemy, you know, did they do a good origin story for the enemy? Yeah, actually, I liked it too. I liked the story behind why we have a big-ass spider. It was good.
Well, to keep up with it, I mean, Greg Gunberg, who we've known from Heroes, and
yeah.
He's done a lot of those B-movies.
Even Star Trek.
Yeah, he was in, well, he had that, he got cut in Star Trek.
Yeah, you hear his voice.
Yeah, and he's got a long history.
Which one was it that he was in?
He was in the first Star Trek.
Star Trek
movie. But
his scene was completely cut. You see,
he was the uncle
scenes.
To mm-hmm. Kirk. He's all, you hear his voice.
Ah, yes.
When young Kirk steals a car.
Yeah,
that's
yeah.
his voice.
The uncle, I thought it was like a stepfather that was.
No, everybody assumed it, but no, it turned out it was like an uncle. It was his uncle.
Mm. But, well, no, I mean, the movie was enjoyable. I mean, the military, where typical military think that they know everything, but they're idiots.
You have to admit, the special effects were really good.
Well, yeah, again, especially the rampage down the.
Well, let's explain something, okay? The special effects to me are good, but they're not like Jurassic Park or.
No. This is a campy movie, and it meant to be. I mean, you know, it's on line with what you were gonna find in a sci-fi movie, you know, of the Sci-Fi Channel version. It's, you know, it's not going to be award-winning, but the thing is this. They were believable. They were fun. I mean, you know that it's cheesy, but the thing is that some cheese is enjoyable. Go ahead and just munch on.
I disagree with you. The special effects were a step up from Sharknado. Okay?
Oh, yeah, yes.
Okay, the special effects were a little bit better.
Well, that was the point I was trying to make.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Don't expect, like,
yeah,
you know, mind-blowing.
Yeah, it's not, yeah. Well,
but it's better than the sci-fi.
Yeah, it's in between.
Yeah,
it's
somewhere.
But, you know, I agree with his point. The special effects can't be that good for this kind of movie.
Oh, no, you have to go ahead.
It would then be ridiculous. I mean, it would. You know what I mean? So, it for the special effects, for what it is, it works. It's appropriate.
But the thing is like, when the spider's going ahead and left and right, going ahead and just wrapping people up in the spider web and just bringing it in, and then, you know, one guy, you know, is just goes ahead and just swallows him whole, and then afterwards burps.
Burping spiders.
One of the other things is that often special effect creatures do not have, at times, you know, yeah, it's rampaging, but they don't have a character to it. And I felt that the big ass spider in this movie had a bit of character. You know, burped at times, went ahead and did, you know, certain things that made me laugh.
Stole
a
quarter.
Yeah. and used that quarter to go ahead and lure a, you know,
We can't say he stole the quarter. He gave it to him.
Well, here's one thing.
Wait. Give me that back. Come on.
Well, here's Tona. Let me point out how detailed the director was. Because some people would just do a CGI thing and, you know, just stick the spider there and all that. This guy had little details. Like, when he walked, he tore holes in the ground.
Yeah.
You know, which to me is like shows this director had a key eye for what he wanted and all that. It showed weight. It gave the character substance. In the bad sci-fi movies that we see, the monster is just there And, you know, it's not affecting the environment. It's not doing anything.
And you know what? Going along with David's point, you know, the reason the spider has so much personality is because of the interaction with the actors with the creature. And that interaction is great. You see the hero and how he interacts with it. And, you know, it's great. You know, you see his interaction with a psychic. It's great. There's really, really solid interaction here. And the monster in the movie, you know, the big-ass spider, isn't detrimental to that. He's actually part of everything, you know what I mean? You also see him in there as a personality, like you said.
Yeah. Talking about the sidekick who's coming to the, you know, to the Sun City Sci-Fi, I mean, I'm excited to go ahead and talk to him because he must have had a lot of fun with this role. Because some of the lines that he had were hilarious.
Well, the whole thing looked like they just, you know, they weren't taking themselves seriously. I said that before. And you really can't. But, you know, there's some actors who do this movie, this type of movie, and they think they're Shakespeare. You know, these guys just said, you know, and the Mexican jokes were there, you know.
It was awful. Well, I mean, it was funny.
The music as they're going ahead and running along. I just love it.
And even the name of the psychic is bad.
Jose.
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 Well,
yeah. Can you get any more
Juan. And then he's going ahead and calling him Juan, and he's going, it's Jose.
He calls him Jose. Yeah. Jorge. Mexican Robin.
El Dorado.
U.S. to Mexico.
Oh, me, I would have been like, are you serious? You know, I was born here.
And your Spanglish is getting in the way.
Importantly, the best thing is, you know, girls in skimpy outfits. We had some.
Yes.
Well, okay, you gotta admit, you know, this film has certain character, especially when you have. thing about her. No name, no nothing, just that.
Girl with the rack.
Well, yep. It was an integral part of the movie.
Chaton Anderson, I think?
Yeah, well, let me give a warning here. Let me give a warning to some parents and all that. There is no nudity here. Okay? No. He didn't go that route. You know, a lot of times, you know, they go that route by doing sex and horror and for no gratuity.
He just kept it with bikinis.
Yeah, but and sometimes nice you're used babes. To seeing, you know, the gratuitous nudity and.
Yeah, no shower scene.
No girl walking nude there. No.
Nothing like out of that one movie with that one Spider-Woman you know, with the girl taking a shower and everything.
Although to go along with this point, there's no nudity, but there's certain scenes that creep people out. It creeped out his wife. So, if you have young children, I wouldn't personally. It didn't scare me, but I don't know. I'm not a young child, so.
Well, for a young teenager.
Yeah, for a teenager, nothing. But five-year-old might be scared of it.
Spiders, you know, and especially, you know, when they're creeping and crawling under the covers and stuff like that.
And that's a good point. It's creepy. It is. The monster right at the beginning is creepy. It is. Yeah.
Well, I was more afraid of him when he was like when he was like hand-sized than he was when he was huge. You know, because when he was small, you know, he's crawling, you can't find him.
One of the things that I found funny is when he does get big, how many people are holding up their cell phones to go ahead and take videos of him instead of going ahead and running the other way?
Which makes complete sense in our society.
I think the director's making a statement.
Yeah.
It was in Little Tokyo.
Well, yeah, they show clips in Little Tokyo. I guess it's a little tribute to, you know, those type of
Godzilla movies and everything.
He's rampaging through Little Tokyo.
The setup to that was great.
Yeah, and I think the director had fun with L.A. You know, because you see some of the L.A. landmarks and all that, and you just get people just getting dying, and you see, like, well, the YouTubers and all that. Oh, I saw a spider! Holler, yeah! And they're really like, we should have been in the background of that.
Oh, God. Well, we would have fit in, dude. It would have been a problem.
Oh, I'm sure they would have given us costumes. now that we've seen the movie and all that, we know the director's coming and all that, you know, I plan on talking to him a lot about this film. You know, like the shooting, mm-hmm. you know, how do you do the shooting and what gave you the idea for this, you know, because he had fun with it. It looks like it was fun. And, you know, there was ideas of what was his goals.
What was he looking for? I know it's not, you know, it's not the most original because they've had Eight-Legged Freaks and all that. But I consider this much better than Eight-Legged Freaks. I mean, you know, this movie just had a certain charm about it.
A certain je ne sais quoi.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah, that's too highbrow for our... Anyways, but you know what? There is a sense of that. As you watch the movie, it looks like everybody's having fun with it. And that's the best part. You can feel it. You can see it as you go through the movie. You know, everybody's having fun. Nobody,
and then,
you know...
And the most important thing is that we had fun.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then, question, without giving anything away, yes or no, sequel?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Well, they said it.
We already saw the...
Yeah, they come on. You don't know. There's a reason why, more than like...
Yeah. And I think he did.
And I would like to see a sequel. I wonder what would happen, you know?
Yeah. I don't know. It's kind of cool.
I think section. The sequel would scare you. It's actually scary. It scares me more than the...
I don't know about the sequel. No, you know, I don't think I'm psychologically equipped to see the sequel.
That I might stay away from.
Okay, now we go ahead and come to the grades. Myself, for what it is, I enjoyed it for what it is. I mean, it's not Shakespeare or anything like that, and I didn't expect it to be. But it is a lot better than what I expected anyway. I enjoyed it for what it is. It's one of those camp films that you can sit with your friends and enjoy. So, myself, I give it an A.
For me, I'm looking at the movie, and I know this was not one of those, you know, it's not Pacific Rim, it's not, it's not Star Trek, okay, the stuff we're used to. And so I had to, again, grade it on its merit. And when I was looking at it, even with the previews, I was comparing it to the sci-fi films, because that's as close as we get now to seeing it. And so, based on that, I gotta say it's a kick up from those type of movies.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed it. I had fun with it. I like the pacing. The story was the story is plain, but it's good and it's straightforward. There's nothing wrong with the basic story. The special effects, again, for what it was actually pretty good. The acting, I mean, none of them took themselves seriously. They were all kind of light, humorous. You know, they kept going. The star of it, Greg Gumberg, I liked him because he did, you know, he was stupid, but he wasn't like really, really, you know, like incredibly, you know, there was some redemption in the guy, which made him likable.
Oh, yeah.
There was some redemption in him, which again, if you're interested, if you find that you relate to that guy, you find him interesting, the movie keeps you going. And this guy held up the movie. So because of that, I give the movie... an A.
Well, looking at everything else and looking at the film as a whole, you know, I liked it, except for the fact that I missed part of it.
Not our fault.
Yeah, I know, and I know who to blame for that. But I liked the film. I was, from what I saw, and I liked everything. I did love the pacing. It didn't feel like I was like, oh God, when is this going on? I hate that, you know, the feeling of, okay, it's dragging, it's like got two left feet, it's lumbering around, no, this movie kept on going, it went, okay, got this, it had its rhythm, and because it had its rhythm, and it was entertaining, and the special effects weren't the best in the world, but they're good, they're very enjoyable, so I have to give it a 92.
Mm-hmm.
Like you mentioned, and I agree with you, pacing was great. You know, I wasn't bored. Once it started, it takes you through the whole thing, you know. There's no point in the movie where you're like, okay, well, you know, it keeps you going.
I like the acting. I like the dialogue. The dialogue was great. Mm-hmm. Like David mentioned, the monster has personality. You know, it's not a static creature. It's not just there. It's actually interacting with everything and everybody, so that's great. The only downside I have, the only thing I didn't like, and well, the one thing I didn't like is what you mentioned, that giant plot hole towards the end, okay? That bugged me, you know? Aside from that, just from that, you know, that's the only thing I didn't like, that plot hole. Aside from that, you know, I give it a B, just for all that. It was great, it was everything. You know, if they didn't have that plot hole, I would have given it an A.
To follow up without spoilers, that ending, yeah, it kind of left it, but I'm thinking they're leaving it open for sequels. Like every monster movie.
Yeah, yeah, could be.
Yeah.
And it's not as big of plot holes as we've seen from major films.
Right, but again, that's why I'm giving it a B. You know? Yeah. Still a plot hole.
I mean, this is not a Batman Rising, you know, Dark Knight Rising level of plot holes here.
And that might be something to bring to the director. They're like, you know, you left.
I wonder what his reaction would be and what he would
who
say.
Who are you? Who are you?
Tell me.
I am the director.
See, I'm out.
And for that, ladies and gentlemen, I just imitated my wife.
Okay.
Well, before we go, though, did we have fun?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was fun. And you know, if you take anything away from the review, the movie's fun.
And, we have the director and one of the stars going ahead and coming to the Sun City Sci-Fi Con.
Yes, Lombardo Boyar is coming, Sun City Sci-Fi, in March.
The girl with the rack.
And also Mike Mendez, the director.
Maybe if we ask nicely, they can bring Girl with Rack and
please,
Nurse Lisa.
Yes.
Nurse Lisa, yeah.
And Victim.
Victim,
oh, Cocoon.
Yeah.
We need Cocoon Victim in. Come on.
Let's bring the girls in the bikini.
Yeah!
Alright.
What about TikTok?
Yeah. That's
the girls in the bikini.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's our show. This was a review of Big Ass Spiders. Hope you, again, rent it. And Sun City Sci-Fi coming in March. Bye.